Hello, welcome to a new electronics video. This one we're using flyback transformers once again. And if you remember that, in a couple of seconds here, I'm going to put a clip of this old flyback transformer video that I made back in, I want to say October. It's a very poor driver, and you can see why right here. Anyway, yeah, so that was a pretty poor driver, so I decided to amp it up a bit. And I same exact flyback transformer as one of my experiments. I think I used a gray one in that video. This is a, I think it's like an 8 amp transformer. Puts out 70 volts, center tap 35, which is what I'm using, rectifying it, smoothing it. 250 volt, 470 microfarad cap, getting about 46 volts at about 8 amps out. That goes into the, that does not go into the oscillating circuit. The oscillating circuit is powered by a 9 volt battery, so that gets oscillated by the 555 timer chip. 3 ohms of resistance between, or 3 k ohms of resistance between 8 and 7, and 2k ohms between 7 and 6. 6 and 2 are connected, 2 and 1 are coupled with a 0.01 microfarad, 1 and 5 are coupled with a 0.01 microfarad. And 3 goes to IRFP250 and MOSFET, which is, which the source goes to the negative, the drain. You want a very thick wire, and you can tell this is much thicker than these flimsy things, because the wire sort of melted, and as you can see, my negative return voltage, it got melted into the board, and same with over here, my whole board melted when I had the MOSFET over there, so I put it on an even larger heatsink, and I'm running the flyback at about 50 volts DC, and really it's not that. 50 volts seems like it's a lot of work to put together, but really it's not. It's very simple to put together, very easy. And I'm getting ZVS-like arcs, which is what I want, and getting a nice hum too. And I had to put a stick here because it was melting the wire and melting the insulation right there, and it was smelling really bad, so I decided to just put this stick there. And that made things a lot easier. And so I'm going to turn it on now. And then I'll show you a couple of other things. We'll discuss some other stuff like hand-wound primary versus using the primary inside the flyback and stuff like that. All right, so I'm going to plug in my voltage now. 50 volts DC. Makes about an 18 kilohertz sound. I could already see some arcing on my board. I tested it with my multimeter when it had batteries, and it said it's using about 4 amps, which is what it's pretty much supposed to do. It's producing a lot of heat. In fact, let's see how long I can leave this there. Let's see if we can get the thing to glow. You hear that hum, too. If you're in a high voltage, you probably like to hear that 60 hertz hum. It's very present with this. Alright. That's enough for the computer monitor flyback. As you can see why it's called a computer monitor flyback, we'll first discharge it and then go over here to the last pin. Those capacitors, you want to discharge the caps and discharge it to ground once more. Now, this is very, very warm. Not hot, but it's very warm, and yeah. Wow. Look at that thing. Thing is just glued in here. Yeah, this breadboard is going to be toast. This thing is not moving at all. Alright. I think it's fine with me. This one isn't though. That one's fine. Just a return ground. Alright, so that's cool. And, that's... Now, I found with computer, if you want like those thick juicy arcs, use computer monitor flybacks and use the internal primaries, because for some reason, I don't know if it's the capacitors or just the design, we'll give you those thick high current arcs that you want. Television flybacks, however, are different. They vary a lot between your different types of arcs. In fact, this one here, I hand wound a primary, and I'm using the internal ones as well. So I'm going to show you the internal primaries first and what those look like. All right, so now I got this hooked up, and the primaries, the internal primaries. And let's see how this arcs. It's going to arc to one of the pins on the bottom. Let's try it. Pretty cool light show. Zoom into it. Alright, that's enough of that. Discharge it. Alright. So, now let's hook up my hand wound coil, which is 10 turns of 12 gauge solid wire from Home Depot. So let's try it. Alright, so our oscillating circuit is hooked up. Now let's plug it in. Can already hear the difference. Smell some ozone. Definitely some monster sparks. It's a lot of current. Zoom in on that. Drawing a lot of current too out of the transformer, like the power supply, I mean. So yeah, that's how much arc you would get with the regular coil that we made. Like, the arcs on this are a little bit longer, and they're more like, how do I explain it? They're less thick, they have more of a length, and they have that crackly too, which the other ones didn't have, but they still have this high current hum. So it comes down to what sparks you like and what sparks you need, really. Imagine that that's about like 100 something degrees right now, maybe 200 degrees. Now, the problem with that is this MOSFET here is probably nearing the 125-130 degree mark. I'm sorry, 165-170 degree mark. I just saw 120 written on something, so that's why I said that. It's very, very hot to the touch. Can almost barely touch it. So that's the problem with drawing too much current. Although, This is an amazing way to use the flyback transformer. Right now I'm actually going to take you through some steps to help you wind your own primary coil, since this is like a tutorial vid basically on flyback transformers. So now we're going to wind our own primary coil, see how that goes. Okay, so here I have an old television flyback transformer. Now obviously this is the high voltage out. I'm not sure what the pins are on the bottom. There are some solder blobs and stuff like here, there, and there. One there. But, I'm just gonna wind my own primary coil and see how it goes. Now what I'm doing with this is, I decided that this, very fancy schmancy, what is this? This is 12 gauge solid wire, or is this 10? We will find out. This is 10. This is 10 gauge solid wire at Home Depot. In the wire section, it's like in the back of the store for me. Basically, you want to start from the bottom, I'd say, and just take it through. I'm just going to start like this, sort of in the middle, and I'm just going to take it. Okay, well, this is where the hard part gets. Bend it. You just want to wrap it around. I'm lucky. I'm so lucky that this has a round ferrite core. Usually flybacks have a square ferrite core, so it's harder. But as you saw in my last one, I was able to do it. There's a lot of friction here. It's the problem. Okay, there we go. You just want to make turns like that. And I'd say go up to about, if you have a thick wire like this, go up to about like maybe 1.5 to 2 feet's worth. I'm sorry, yeah, like 2, or a little more than 2 feet's worth, that's fine. And see how many winds you could fit in. I'd say no more than 13 windings is good. I mean, if you have somewhere between like 7 and 13, that's perfect. Because my big one over there has 10, and you saw the difference between the internal windings and the self-made windings, and there was a huge difference. That's because the internal windings, I think, are very thin. They're not thick at all. And honestly, if you have all the parts and you can create thick arcs like that, that's a good replacement for a neon sign transformer for Tesla coils. You don't even have to make a ZVS driver to make a Tesla coil. You can just use it with a 555 if you have a high current one like that. Works. Just make sure you find a 555 that's suitable for it. And I'm going to pause this video now while I finish it, but I just want to tell you first, I'm going to be making a TL494 flyback driver sometime in March, because my stupid chips from Thailand have not even shipped yet, and I ordered them back in January. So, yeah. So I'm just going to wind this coil now. Here we go. Completed coil. I believe it's 13 turns, 3, 6, 9... 12, 13 turns, and I added these little things to make it easier to put into a breadboard. So I'm not sure which way it goes, but we'll test it this way first. With this end going to the positive 50 volts. Alright. This breadboard's gonna be just toast when I'm done with it. You know, we can move this over. This end going right here. To there. And this end going into there. We'll plug in our oscillator circuit. First, let's put this in our chicken stick. Let's move it over to this side. Okay. Plug in oscillator. Positive came out. Both of them came out. Okay.
One problem with breadboards. Actually, that's a total lie. It's one of the many problems with breadboards.
Okay, this is all set up. Alright, let's plug it in and see what happens. Look at that. Thank you. definitely one of the best right there I've got out of any of them. Let's see. Voltage is actually arcing the. There you go. And that's your homemade primary coil. And that one worked very well. And honestly, that's less. I think more windings for your primary is actually going to be less strain on your MOSFET. Like, compared to 10 windings here. 13 windings here for the same amount of time on is not as hot for my MOSFET. So that's a plus. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. Very awesome circuit. And I would say if you're a beginner going into high voltage, build the basic 555 timer circuit. See my other video for that. That's labeled 555. Simple 555 flyback driver. And this is going to be the advanced 555 flyback driver. It's more of a high power version. That'll be the title of this video. So, I encourage you to build one of these. If you're sick of small purple sparks and you want big sparks, build one of these. Thanks for watching.